R.I.P.
Bro, I'm sitting the Taj method down, bro.
That's a good method, bro.
All right, R.I.P. Robert Williams, man. Man. Y'all remember him?
Robert. You know, you say Robert.
Robin.
Right.
It's Robin. Oh,
Robin. Robin said last Williams.
He be saying. He pronounced somebody's name.
I be doing it bad, so too, though.
Funny. It was, how did he say
I be doing that all the time,
I be doing it
bad, so y'all.
This is the least amount of tabs I've ever seen.
Yeah, this is not like WAP.
That's actually weird to see.
What's the name of that movie he was on?
With the cartoons.
Let me see.
I don't know anything about the turd. I'm thinking about the old grandma. I'm thinking about the grandma. I remember he was doing.
When he got his divorce.
He became the nanny.
Oh, I remember that.
I know what you talk about.
It was a Disney movie when we was kids. When somebody, he was like sick or something.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
R.I.P. though, man.
I've seen him in a lot of movies, though.
And those things that he helped, ask for help, bro.
Okay, man. So he
don't want to commit suicide. You remember he committed suicide?
I know that.
You never know. He's the type of world. Yeah.
All right, man.
Always reach out to
him. Let's go and get him, man. I didn't even know this guy did stand up, guys. My first time.
God, let's go and get him. Yeah, I thought he was just an actress.
Yeah, I did not know this. He is multi-talented.
That's an actress.
Well, this is what I'm talking about.
A little sip of Perrier here. I had to stop drinking alcohol because I used to wake up nude and hood in my car with my keys in my ass.
No, thanks, this just flooded. I'll be okay.
You're sucked into drinking beer by believing it's a healthy thing. All these beer commercials usually show big men, manly men doing manly things. You've just killed a small animal. It's time for a light beer. Women have a realistic beer commercial. What's the realistic thing about beer? Where you go, it's 5 o'clock in the morning. You've just pissed on a dumpster. It's Miller time. Because you realize the first purpose of alcohol is to make English your second goddamn language. Eventually, you may be quite fluent. You may be a Nobel Prize physicist. After maybe 9, 10 Heinekens, you go, you're speaking fluent drunkenese. Bravo. Next thing you know, you get a couple more beers, you've got a friend in a headlock going, I love you, little fucker, I love you. That's the kind of love I have for you, baby, goddammit. And you work your way beyond beer. You go beyond beer, you start into wine. For the very elegant people, people who are very elegant are in Montauk going, damn it, I wish I could have been there, but no, I'm not. Some people who have, I don't know whether they have the red wine or the fish or the chicken. What's the matter, asshole? They're dead. The chicken's not going to reach up from the plate and go, the red wine. It's over with. No, you know what I'm saying? And I'm not talking about pre-fusse or pussy-fussy.
Yeah, he's a pussy-fussy.
I'm talking about Mad Dog 2020. You know, the very elegant wine, the type of wine with a lovely screw top. A bottle
y'all
of...
Y'all know what Mad Dog is, right?
Never heard of it.
You bro, it got the MD on it. The little... It got the...
No, that's not bad.
That is Mad Dog.
Nah, I think it's Mad Dog.
That's in the gas system. Different colors.
Yeah, they got the MD 2020. That's Mad Dog.
I don't know.
That's the only Mad Dog I know.
But he said, he said with the screw to bottle.
I think that is kind of like wine, but they got alcohol.
You see where he got that chip stuff.
That's that Mad Dog.
Yeah. We can go get that across the street.
Right now. Be still going.
Yeah, that is bad.
You know, the very elegant wine, the type of wine with a lovely screw top, a bottle of which after you can actually see vapor trails as people pass you. How you doing? I've gone too far, and you must pay your dues. This is why I had to give up alcohol, because you have to pay the next day. Pray, dear Lord, please don't hurt me now. There you are, lying in bed, and you feel like the scene from the movie The Fly going, help me! Help me! The entire room is spinning like a roulette wheel. Place your bets. Place your bets.
You know what I mean?
And there's the old toilet in the corner going, like, talk to me.
It's day of, but the next day I'll be good.
Okay.
The next day I'm happy.
Man, like, I don't care. I got so drunk. I thought Jeffrey Dahmer was. Hey,
no, I remember he told me that. I swear to God, he told me I was crying.
I was so weak.
He said, bro, he could have got exposed that night. He said he couldn't have did nothing. He was that drunk.
For real?
That's pretty bad, bro.
I hate this.
he watched the whole documentary.
The Joe had.
That was like right after. That was right after. So he messed up.
No, huh? Hey, I was having a heart attack in my room, bro. My door was locked. I was like, you ever just cried the guy?
I can't handle my liquor or something. I don't know, bro. I can't
I was drinking too much, man.
And you did this three times.
Over drinking.
And you try and walk slowly, but you feel like the elephant man in a car wash. There's things in front of you like the stuff that scares the water off cars. You can't do it. Even your dog's looking at you like, you wouldn't believe the shit you said to me last night. I had to back out of the room. I was that scared. You promised me an evening with Lassie, you lying bastard. Yes, you've got an alcoholic problem. You do. And the worst part is there are times when you drink so much, you don't remember what you've done the night before. And you get those little phone calls where people let you know. What? Yeah? Really? I took a dump in your tuba? Oh my God, he said sit in with the band. I'm sorry. Oh God, it's over. Oh, don't you see? It's all over. God damn it. And then the next thing you know, there you are at Betty Ford Hospital going, I'm fine now. I'm a reformed alcoholic. I feel so much better about myself. I am fine. No, you have that double vodka. I'll be over in the corner kicking the cat. I realized when I became a reformed alcoholic, I said, hey, I'm the same asshole. I just have fewer dents in my car. And then there are your friends who smoke marijuana going, yeah, man, alcohol's a crutch. Really? Really, Captain Herbal Life? Really? God, you just macrame'd your ass into the couch and you're giving me shit? Remember when you get so stoned you can actually see a fly in space going, and when you get stoned, your discretion goes out the window. You could be eating kitty litter going, this is crunchy, man.
Matter of fact.
And it's horrible for people who get stoned, try and get their animals stoned to make them feel better. It's not bad enough that you proved that Darwin was wrong. You're going to take the whole family with you. Please don't do this to me. I've just learned to lick my own genitals. Leave me alone. And your dog, you go, hey, Farfel. Dog says, whoa, my tail, my tail. Don't push him back down the food chain. Don't do that. And don't mess with your cat because he's looking at you like, give it your best shot, man. Yeah. I've been doing catnip since the day I was goddamn born. Come on, catnip, you're blowing his face. All of a sudden, he's Ram Kitty. He looks at you like, the first thing I'm going to do, man, is climb you like a goddamn curtain. Then a double dip pump. Then 15 times around the house real quick. Then outside by the window making this noise. Like a baby in a blender. And you're inside stone going, oh, God, help me now. And the next thing is you start to get hungry. You think you can leave the house, you liar. I'm gonna be fine, man. I've got to leave the house. I'm gonna be okay. If you could just find your goddamn feet, yeah, you'll be okay. Then you think you can drive. You think, yeah, I'll be okay. I'll drive. I'll be okay. And you have one of those new Japanese cars where you open the door and it goes, your door is open. And if you're stoned, you're going, I knew that. So you get in the car, you think, yes, I'm now, I've cut it. I'm the keys, okay, fine. The keys, fine. Okay, reverse, fine, okay. Then you're going down the freeway, you think you're traveling at light speed. You think Scotty's sitting next to you going, Jim, you can't push it any faster. It's just a shoveling engine. Don't drag it over the edge. Your hair is blowing in the wind, and the window isn't even open. You're about to tone. You turn on the radio. What is he? You understand everything. Yeah. Suddenly on the radio, man's stoned on freeway. How do they know? God damn it. I'm okay. I'm fine. Yeah, suddenly in the rearview mirror. Red, white, and blue. How patriotic. Yeah. Shit, the police. Eat everything in the ashtray. Oh, God. Oh, pull it over. All of a sudden, you start rehearsing. What seems to be the problem, officer? I'm fine. What seems to be the problem? Nice day, officer. What seems to be the problem? Usually, you're stopped by a motorcycle cop.
He gets off his bike, like, God, am I incredibly well endowed? I'll get your door. There you go. From inside your car comes this Colombian sauna, like, suddenly he's going, I'm hungry, I don't know why. You're looking at him. You've rehearsed your line. What seems to be the problem? What seems to be the problem? You look at him and go,
yo, we
didn't
take it to the
scene.
That's
my fear, bro.
You look at him, his face turns into a cheeseburger. You lunge! Next thing you know, you end up in a cell. Go, please don't hurt me. But the truth is, you wake up and you're still on the couch at home. You've never left. You're still there.
That's too I ate too loud.
That was good.
Nice. I ain't gonna lie, he could describe some things.
I can see how he was such a good actor, man. R.I.P. Robin Williams.
Man, I don't even know who that is. That's crazy. That's I did not even know that happened, bro.
Yeah.
When did that happen?
It happened 2010, 2010.
It was like 15.
For real?
I think it was in college, bro.
No, it was in high school. I thought it was middle school.
No, I was in high school.
I don't even know this happened.
It was like 2015, 2016.
Yeah, he's goated, man. I did not know a ton of movies of this guy.
No, he got a lot of movies.
A ton of movies, like so many.
Man, what was
I didn't even know the guy's name. Me.
Is he called Mrs.?
I know exactly what you're talking about.
He, like, when he broke up with his wife and
so many, bro. He was goated, bro.
Yeah, he became the little nanny. He was watching the kids so he could be with his kids, and the kids knew about the mama. Had a new play coming through. He was getting hot.
Funny, bro. He's up there, guys. Let us know some more. We will definitely do some more Robin, man. We're going, man. We appreciate it. Let's get it.